Okay, if you have a table of data in Google Sheets and you want to look at it by a certain type of date, let's say if you want to look at it by month or you want to look at it by week, the first thing that you want to do is create a pivot table. So you'll notice that I've selected a cell within this table of data that I want. The table goes down, but Google Sheets will figure out that you want the whole thing as long as you're inside of it. And make sure you don't have any blank rows. So do data, pivot table. And this is going to summarize the data that's on sheet one, but it creates it on a new worksheet. And what we want to do is we want to start out with having the dates down the left-hand side, and then we're going to group the dates, look at them in different ways. So we want the rows to be dates. So do add date. And when I look back at my table, this is a lot easier if you just have descriptive headers. So each one of these is telling me exactly what's in the column. So I have my dates on the left-hand side, and then I want to do it by item in each column. So let's add items to the columns. And then Sheets wants to know what to put in here. So I'm going to tell it, put the sum of the amount for each day in here, because I'm going to look at the sales. So for the values, add amount, and it's smart enough to assume that you probably want the sum. And if you don't want these grand totals on here, you just take this check mark off to not show totals. We're going to leave them on for what we're doing, but they're easy to customize. We're just going to do months, but it's going to work the same way as if you do weeks. Come over to the column that has the days on it. Select any one of the days, right click and do create pivot date group. Doesn't matter what day you pick. It's going to do this for all of them. And you can do this by week, by month. You can even do it by day of the week. But just to keep things easy, we'll do month. And it summarizes all of the data from sheet one into each month. Now, this will only work if you have them as valid dates. So if you have things in this column that aren't working right, you go back to your data and make sure that these are valid. There's several different ways to get valid dates and to check and make sure that they're working. I'll put a little link in the upper right-hand corner here. So that's mostly it. We've summarized this data by month with just a few clicks. And if you like that tutorial, there's a lot of others just like it. If you subscribe to my channel in the lower right-hand corner, you'll see them as they come out. Thanks. Bye.